to configure port forwarding on a clear router to allow the ports through for your DVR-7000 series standalone DVR, first open up your web browser and enter in http://, then the IP address that you got from the IP config on your computer for the gateway. This is the IP address of your router, so it will allow you to get into the configuration of the router. So for our example, it was 192.168.1.1. Once it opens up, it will ask you to log in with a password. Type in your password and then click Login. If you don't know your password, you'll have to check back with your internet service provider. Next, click on Port Forwarding in the top right. Once the page loads, click on Forwarding in the bottom left. In the first line, for WAN port start, enter in 9000. Then for WAN port end, enter 9000. The LAN IP address will be the number that you got from the network configuration page of your DVR. For our example, it was 192.168.1.100. For the LAN port start, you will also enter 9000, and the LAN port end will be 9000 as well. The enabled box should remain checked, and then click on Apply in the bottom right to add this to the list of forwarded ports. Next, we'll click on Add again to add another line. This time, for WAN port start and WAN port end, we'll add in port 80. Then enter the same IP address that you got from the DVR's network configuration page. Then enter 80 for LAN port start and LAN port end. Make sure that the enabled box is checked and click on Apply to add it into the router's rules. Click on Add again to add a third line. In this line, for WAN port start and WAN port end, we will add in 15961, which is the mobile port which will be used for your iPhone or Android phones. For the IP address, once again, enter in the IP address you got from the DVR's network settings page. For LAN port start and LAN port end, enter in 15961. Now click on Apply to apply the rule. Double-check the ports in all of the rules. Make sure that it has 9000 to 9000, 80 to 80, and 15961 to 15961. Also double-check the IP address on each line to ensure that it matches the IP address of the DVR from the DVR's network settings page. Once this is done, we'll be ready to check to make sure that the ports are open. Next, we need to check to make sure the ports are open. Go back to the address bar of your web browser and type in http://canyouseeme.org. That will open up a page that looks like this. At the top, it will give you your external IP address, which is the IP address that you will use in your phone or PC remotely over the internet for connecting in. Next, type in our first port, 9000, and click on Check. Down below the ad, you'll see either a success or a error message. Here, success means that our port forwarding is correct. Next, test port 80 as well, checking once again for success. Then we will test the final port, 15961, which is the mobile port. Check that port as well. And as you can see here, we're also getting a success message, meaning that all of our ports are open. However, if you get an error, that means that your port forwarding is not correct. Check back with the settings inside of your router in order to determine if the correct ports, as well as correct IP address, are being used in the forwarding. Also, make sure that the DVR is turned on. Once the ports are open, you will be able to connect in from the outside.